Your actions today will determine your future, your state of happiness and sorrow. All unions in this world between spouses, friends, family members are all false and dreamlike. Only one union is possible, and that is the union with God, the ultimate. This is the reason that masters like Kabir, Nanak, Dadu, they go on calling themselves to be the bride of Ram. Kabir says he has understood one can only be Ram's bride. There alone all barriers will vanish. There alone will disappear all thirst. In that alone will vanish all distances and separations. Before this, kind of restlessness will remain. You may try to quench your thirst, but the thirst remains. You may try to quench your thirst, but that thirst will remain. In the process of all this, you will accumulate many new actions. Totality of all such accumulated actions will determine your life tomorrow and also your state of happiness and sorrow. Each moment, as the light has come and activates your thought process, it reaches to the level of the body through organs of perception and action. You interact in the world of objects and beings. As your thought process, in the same way, you will interact with the people. I have heard a question was posed to a lawyer. Sir, have you known anything like the Indian scriptures Ramayana and Mahabharata? He said, yes, I have studied them. What do you think of Mahabharata? It is a clear case of land dispute. Mahabharata is a clear case of land dispute. And Ramayana is a clear case of kidnapping. And for such trivial act, so much of warfare is not justified. I could have solved this matter out of the court. This is the bent of mind of the people. Your inner state keeps on changing until you attain to awakening, and it is in that light you interact in the world of objects and beings. Just as a lawyer has a particular bent of mind, way of looking at the things, so too this keeps on changing moment to moment with the person. And with that, you interact. And this will determine your tomorrow. After you have spoken to the person out of anger, what happens? That is your experience. Your anger today will create an impulse. And then such impulse will become a way of life, which Hindus call a sanskar. And these sanskars will determine your life. The lawyer has spent nearly 20 years in obtaining a degree in law. He has developed certain way of thinking, and whatsoever he will speak in that terminology. Only an enlightened one does not live by such impressions. The sanskars are set of impressions that are gathered in your mind. If you are living a particular life, way of life, your language, your way of speaking and gestures will be guided by that. Then these impressions or sanskars become your habit and ultimately your life pattern. Your actions determine your habits. The law of action is not philosophic, it is very scientific. It is just the principle of psychology. All that you do creates a tendency in you to repeat. All repetitions are mechanical. People inquire how to control or manage anger. It is just not in the earth. No one wants to be angry, yet still it happens. And afterwards they have to repent. You know, anger is habitual. It is very difficult to break the habit. You can do at least one thing. Now stop repenting. This much you can do. This you will not agree. You are taught that after you get angry, you must repent and you must apologize. But remember, first you tried to control or manage your anger and you failed. Even your repentance has been of no use. Not that you have asked me, there is no choice. You could not change the habit of getting angry for no reason. Also, repenting again and again afterwards was not helpful. Now you try another alternative. You find sometimes anger is necessary. You have to get angry because of the other. But repentance is in your hand. This is not your habit either. This you can leave. In anger, the other is involved. Someone abused you or did something or said something which is not acceptable to you. Anger is spontaneous. Only you repent, and that too all alone. This has nothing to do with the other. You will find to leave repentance even more difficult than getting angry. A lady used to come in meditation. Since she was married, she was behind her husband to quit drinking. One day she said, for the last 20 years she has been trying and nothing seems to work. Even talks do not matter. A man who has been drinking for the last 20 years has become habitual. Now the wine has entered various cells of her body and the blood as well. I told the woman, this I will handle later on. For this you have to do one thing. Stop nagging and asking your husband to quit drinking for 3 months. The third day the person came back and said, this she cannot do. She is habitual of asking him to quit drinking. Like 3 times you are taking the dose of the medicine. I asked the person, now you can see how difficult it will be for your husband to quit drinking. You cannot leave nagging and you want your husband to change his 20 years of drinking habit. It is a matter of just 3 months. If you can give me a proof that you can change your habit, then I will ask your husband. She realized the difficulty. Her husband drinks only 2 times and she nags at least 8 to 10 times per day. This nagging has become intoxication for her. habits are intoxications, and your repetition strengthens the habit. The principle simply says your doing any act increases the possibility of its happening further. You are staying in the guest house and behaving as if you are at home. You are inculcating a bad habit. The guest house will not one day, but all your thoughts and all that you have done there will form a chain of actions. This will accompany you, therefore introspect. You have taken away something from someone that will not be one day, but the action will remain with you. That will be your treasure. If you are doing something wrong, you are leading your future in wrong direction. If your life is full of awareness, then your efforts are to change your life in right direction. The more aware you are, it will be easy to quit the habit. A meditative person, always awake in all circumstances, he can develop a habit and he can drop it the very next moment. I have heard about a Zen master. He used to carry a bag on his shoulder. Someone asked about what is awareness. He was standing, he dropped the bag and walked away. And then he came back, picked up the bag and walked away. You have developed a habit. You can drop it the very moment. Something that you have liked and cherished, someone asks for it, you just give it to him and no thought of that comes to your mind again. No attachment. A meditative person is always awake in all circumstances, even in the sleep. Awake and then you can arise. That's why the Hindu scriptures use two words, awake and arise. Be awake that this world and its dualities are not worth lamenting even for a moment. So too your ego is not so relevant that you can create trouble for this. If someone abuses you, do not bother. He may have his reasons. You need not bother. There is crowd. It seems chaotic. However, within this chaos, there is a harmony. Everyone has a purpose. Each is seeking his own direction. No one is concerned with you. Here in this chaos, everyone is busy in his own game. You may get sometimes pushed because of the crowd. If you can see this, introspect and be aware, anger will vanish. Hate will be no more and jealousy will dissolve. And with this will evolve. With this will dissolve all actions. Why do actions arise? Because of anger, because of hate, because of this, because of that. That day compassion will overflow because everyone here is unconscious. With this, the nature of your action will begin to change. The process of transformation will begin. Nanak says understanding and compassion are the ornaments that a wise always wears. You have your ornaments like earrings, necklace, bangles and so on and so forth. Nanak says understanding and compassion are the most precious ornaments of the awakened one. Understanding is awakening, and compassion is the outcome of the change in your understanding and action. Listen to this again. Understanding is awakening, and compassion is the outcome of change that has taken place in your understanding, and with understanding your actions will undergo change. Ignorance breeds violence. Out of understanding and awakening, compassion overflows like the light of the diamond. Actions determine thinking, and thoughts guide actions. It is important to know your thought pattern. There is a relation between the, when you think, what you think is not so important. What you think is not so important. What you really do out of that thinking is really important. I may think of slapping you. It does not matter. But my slapping you will really matter, because that is an action that is expressed in the outer world of objects and beings. What you think is not so important. What you do is really important. Your action is the proof of your thought. Thoughts of the sinners may be good, but not their actions. In the name of good, in the name of good thoughts, bad actions take place. Your thoughts are insignificant. All that you do will determine you. What you think does not matter. It is very strange, whenever you have to do anything good, you go on postponing for another day because there is no hurry. And whenever you have to do something wrong, you never want to postpone it for tomorrow. You know very well, once postponed, you can never do again. If you want to kill someone, you have to do it now. Have you heard someone saying that all good deeds you will do now and anger another day? It does not happen that way. In the last century, there was a Russian Sufi master, Gurdjieff. Gurdjieff was only 9 years of age when his father died. The dying father said, whenever anger comes to you, for whatever reason, postpone it for 24 hours. You may not understand this now. This is my only pressure. Whenever you will understand this, your life will be transformed. Gurdjieff promised his dying father. Gurdjieff wrote later that this simple device transformed his life. Anger is instantaneous. You cannot be angry after 24 hours. The actual situation, circumstance and situation has happened. After 24 hours, you will realize how foolish it was to get angry in the first place. And then it becomes impossible to get angry. Sometimes try. Stop any wrongdoing and never stop anything good. Your life will undergo transformation. As you are now, you go on engaging in wrongdoings and postponing all that is good and auspicious. In this case, the long chain of your actions become a bed of thorns. Nanak says, all thoughts belong to actions. God alone is truth, so is his quote. Remember, the moment you attain to truthfulness, you enter his abode. You can deceive the whole world, but you cannot deceive yourself. People go on asking how to attain to God. This is the wrong question. You should ask instead how to attain to truthfulness. And people inquire why God is not possible. The real question should be, why God is not visible to me? If you are false, you cannot see Him. To see truth, you need different kind of eyes, true eyes. To experience truth, you have to be true. Only truth can recognize truth. As you are, your whole structure is false. By false, I do not mean the falsehood that you speak. Instead, your very being is false. To rest on wrong foundation, your face, gestures, and behavior are all false. There is no coordination between your thoughts and words. There is no coordination between your thoughts, words, and actions. You are not sure of your own existence. Sometimes when people are speaking, through their gestures, they may be speaking a very soft, a pleasant word, but the gestures are that of acrimony. You cannot deceive. You will be afraid as you will be afraid as you begin to be true. Your house that you built in this guest house like world will start falling. Guest house implies a temporary resting place. The biggest lie that you have created around you is that you have created a house around you. Furthermore, you want to sail your paper boat. It is dangerous. Even to bring the boat to water is dangerous. You will remain on the shore. People inquire what will happen if I start the path of truth and righteousness. The life will become difficult. Indeed, that will happen. You have built your structure on the foundation of falsehood. It will be difficult in the beginning. If you do not change, you are in trouble. And if you decide to change, even then you are in problem. You have not known happiness. No flower has blossomed in your life. Bliss you have not known. There is no reason that you can say life is worth living. Can you say any moment, life is worth living? Life is difficult. But you have become accustomed to this. When you will try to change in reality, then habit will break. All habits begin to break life, and that will, all habits begin to break life will move in a new direction. Your world will be meaningless. Your eyes and gestures will speak of inner happiness. Each cell of your being will overflow ecstasy. Your true nature is really tested in front of God. Your readiness can only be tested then. One who cannot stand in front of God and thus disappear is not yet ready. And one who stands firm in front of God, he is ready indeed. Make this your guiding principle. Do whatever you want to be meditating. I do not ask you to leave this or that. If you want to thief, go ahead and do it. If you want to engage in any activity, do it. But be meditative. Be aware that you are going to thief. Whatsoever you do, it does not matter to me. But one thing that matters to me, that you are aware that you are going to do it. And when awareness comes, you cannot engage into that and remain a witness to all that is happening in and around you. Be like a goldsmith who tests the gold before he takes any decision. You go to sell your gold ornament. He has this piece of black stone. He rubs the part of the gold onto that to know the purity of the gold. A potter makes clay pots and then bakes them in the fire. All unbaked pots will melt in the rain. However, the baked one will accumulate water. And whenever you go to buy a clay pot, you test the sound of the pot. There is a basic difference in the sound of the two pots. There is a particular composition of Jalaluddin Rumi on baking. As your being begins to be ready, the sound will change. A new echo will arise in your being. You can now hear the existential sound within first, and then its echo will disseminate into your outer realm. You will start getting his whispers, and these whispers will bring a different serenity and a joy. A new contentment will overwhelm your being. Sahajobai, one of the woman mystic from Rajasthan, says, "Bin ghan parat puhar, no clouds are seen, yet still there is a drizzle. There are no clouds visible, and yet still there is drizzle, a pleasant drizzle. You are happy for no reason. For no reason, each cell of your being smiles as if a spring has come. Thousand flowers have blossomed all around. It appears the aura, the atmosphere has become of the color of the spring, is soaked in the color of the spring. And each morning of yours has become a golden ray of light. Each morning has become golden, and that golden hue fills your morning and evening at dawn and dusk. At the dawn and dusk of life, the golden ray fills you, and with that, as the spring has come, the flowers have blossomed, their beauty and fragrance fills the breeze. And when the breeze blows and touches your nostrils, holds on to your clothes, just as when a child goes with the mother, he holds on to the clothes of the mother, that is known as Achal, the grave. There alone you will want to dwell moment to moment. There alone this intoxicated mind wants to soar and reach, where the sky, the vast sky, appears to be full of the golden hue. I wish to place my being, my mind, my innerness there. Appears as if everything is becoming a golden hue within and without. As your being begins to be ready, the sound will change, a new echo will arise in your being. You can now hear the existential sound within first, and then its echo will disseminate in the outer realm. You will start getting his whispers, and these whispers will bring a different serenity, a new joy, a new contentment will overwhelm your being. Sahajobai says, "Bin ghan parat fuhar, no clouds are seen, yet still there is a drizzle. You are happy for no reason. For no reason, each cell of your being smiles. You have not received any treasure, yet still a new bliss dances deep within." A bliss dances deep within? Yes, it is so. It is a deep, a new bliss dances deep within you. Walk gaily, frisking, flying. As you start ripening, the pot of your being shall start filling with the water of bliss. The unbaked pot will melt as you put the water into it. Once it is baked, as you start ripening, as more and more treasures are received, the pot will start filling with the water of the bliss. Do not wait. Each moment you are taking a new birth. One moment dissolves into the other. Each moment as it dissolves into the unfathomable ocean, two things happen simultaneously. A moment dies, another is born. You are experiencing simultaneously death and life. You will realize life and death are two sides of the same coin. If you are right, there will not be any gap. The moment, this very moment, dissolves, another is born. Do not wait. Each moment you are taking a new birth. One moment dissolves. The lotus leaf has a drop on its surface. Look, the drop dissolves in the lake. Another drop falls and settles on the rose, on the lotus leaf. Process continues. Begin from now. Only then you can be in front of him. As such much time has been wasted. Live each finite moment meditatively. And when you are living meditatively, you are living with God as your ultimate flowering. And that alone is your abode. And never forget this world is a guest house. Never forget this world is a guest house. Only this much for now.